Thanks be to God, which giveth
us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A lesson from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Bring forth the people who are blind yet have eyes, who are deaf yet have ears. Let all the nations gather together and let the peoples assemble. Who among them has declared this and foretold to us the former things? Let them bring their witnesses to justify them, and let them hear and say, it is true. You are my witnesses, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, so that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me no God was formed, nor shall there be any after me. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. I declared and saved and proclaimed, then there was no strange God among you, and you are my witnesses, says the Lord. I am God, and also henceforth I am he. There is no one who can deliver from my hand. I work, and who can hinder it? Here endeth the lesson.
My soul doth magnify the Lord.
A lesson from the first letter of Peter. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow into salvation. If indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good, come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourself be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, "See, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word, as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." Here endeth the lesson.
Oh,
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful.
We entreat thee, O Lord,
that thy holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill.
We entreat thee, O Lord,
that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses.
We entreat thee, O Lord,
that there may be peace to thy church and to the whole world.
We entreat thee, O Lord,
that we may depart this life in thy faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ.
We entreat thee, O Lord,
that we may be bound together by the Holy Spirit in the communion of Saint John the Evangelist and all thy saints, and trusting one another and all our life to Christ.
We entreat thee, O Lord.
Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery hast established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship thee, all nations obey thee, all tongues confess and bless thee, and men and women everywhere love thee and serve thee in peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, even unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love, the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, who hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication unto thee, and hast promised through thy well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, thou wilt be in the midst of them, fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen.
The love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.